I'm being joined by Maxime Vachier-Lagrave, the French number one. Congratulations for your two victories in the Schachbundesliga 2019. And most important, you made it. You become 13 times Schachbundesliga champion in the Schachbundesliga. How was the feelings during that game? Was that a lot of pressure?
Yes, the match was a lot of pressure. And when I got this winning position quite quickly, I felt I need to win, and I was trying to be careful, and at some point I was too careful, and Harry came back, so because I lost some tempi trying to deprive him of any counterplay, but it turned out I left him with a lot of counterplay, and at some point it was even a draw, so I guess you could put that on pressure.
Yes, and the game looked very sharp. So you played the opening moves very sharp and very quick. And with this queen move from black, was it all preparation or theory or freestyle?
It was preparation, and I had already played most of this line against Vichy last year. So it was actually mainstream theory as soon as it's played. So. And up until rook e2, it was all theory.
At one moment, there was a chance, such as sacrificing the rook for Hari Krishna. Do you think it would be a draw if he would have seen this, or?
It would have been a draw, of course.
But full point is a full point. Is really, really amazing.
Yeah, no, it was very important for us to win this match. So, yeah, I'm very happy, but all of us are very happy to have won the match and the title.
I think the team captain, Sven Nobis, was very released after you have won your game.
But yesterday he was not the team captain. Yesterday it was Etienne. But yes, it was a relief, and but there was still one game remaining, so we couldn't relax yet.
Okay, and a very strong chess tournament is waiting for you in 2 weeks, the Grenke Chess Classic 2019. What are your thoughts about it?
I think it's my third time going there, so I always enjoyed it. So I really hope to do well. I know the field is extremely strong as always, so right now I'm sort of getting back into shape. I won my last 4 games in Bundesliga, so I hope to keep the trend going.
Really cool. As I wish you all the best for the games there. And the chess world is changing very much. Chess servers such as chess.com started to put chess a bit in this gaming direction, in this esports direction. Do you think chess live streaming and chess as a game, not like Counter-Strike, but like other games, do you think that can be the future?
I think it's part of the future and actually part of the present, because chess.com has this global idea, which includes like streaming by players, including myself, and all sorts of nice events that you can play online. So I think it's just a different type of chess than over the board chess, whether it is classical or blitz tournaments. Online it's quite different, but I think this new approach can generate new players, in general, new interest for chess. So I think both online and over the board chess will cohabitate.
Have you think so too? Do you stream yourself on Twitch or YouTube?
I do stream on Twitch. MVL Chess is my channel, and I've been streaming for like the past 3 months, but of course during tournaments it's more difficult for me to stream, so I don't stream as regularly as others.
Thank you very much. We wish you all the best for the Grenke Chess Classic 2019, and you have prepared the critical moments of your game against Hari Krishna for us today.
So, for this game, Hare Krishna played as a Paulsen, which I, as a Taimanov, I mean, which I didn't really expect. But I was anyway ready to play this line with Queen F3, which I played already against Vichy last year in Gwen Kutcher's Classic. So A3 was the start of the new ideas because F4 is the main line here, but A3 was a move that Etienne found for me, and well, it's been quite successful. So the point after bishop b7, you take. If black takes, queen b8, now you have bishop b6, and you just win because of knight c7. So which is why black has to play rook c8, and then it's all forced. And well, it shouldn't really be better for white, because there's a pair of bishops and the center for black, but the king is still in the center, so a lot of things can happen. And this is where I deviated from my game with Vichy, because against Vichy, I think I took, played queen d6, king g8, f4, and here, if I remember correctly, queen c4. Queen takes d7, bishop f7 is good for black, because I cannot take on e6 because of queen a2, and if king b1, e5. So I only had memories that rook e2 was the correct move, but then for a moment I didn't know what to do against e5, and then I saw this idea with queen h3. So you cannot take on d6 because I simply take and play queen e6 check, then get the rook on c8. But for a moment I wasn't sure what to do after queen c3, and then I noticed I take, king g8, now he returns queen a1 mate, but I have the beautiful move rook d3. So now if queen a1 check, I have king d2. And most importantly, if bishop takes e6, now I have queen e6 mate because the bishop cannot go to f7. And if queen takes d3, queen takes e8, and it's gonna be mate. So, so he couldn't play queen c3. And I'm guessing this is what he missed, because then he had to play rook d8, but after b4, queen a4. So now it's very important that the rook is not on c8 for when I play b4, because here, so this is a point, if b4, I think queen d5, queen b3, queen c4 is good for black. So which is why the rook on d8 is very important. And now I just take, and I thought it would just be a matter of technique, because I mean, I can already take on a6. What I chose to do is probably also very good. So with f4, I knew I would get some material along the way. Then I started to play too careful, to try to avoid any counterplay on the king side with g5 and f4. And it proved to be a bit shaky, so I played rook f2. I didn't want to allow counterplay, so it goes rook f8. Rook d3. Wait. His rook was on b8, of course. His rook was on b8. It doesn't really matter. Didn't make a big change, but. Anyway, yes, around here. Then he played the good move rook b8, and I realized if I go h5, rook c5, h takes g6, rook takes c5, it's not over yet. So I finally decided to play rook c3, but then he got bishop d5. And, well, it was a new story. So, okay, I still thought I'm winning. So here he started to play good moves. Hang on. This cannot be the... Oh, no, of course, yeah. I had to play rook e2 because b5, king takes e5 is a draw. So I played rook e2, then he go f4, b5, bishop a8, yeah. This is the correct position. So king d4, h6, c4, g5, hg, hg. And here, I made the mistake, I missed his idea, because I wanted to get c5, g4, rook c2, which might still be a draw, but after c5 I only considered g4, I didn't consider bishop d5. Instead, I should have played rook c2 first. So g4, the line goes g4, c5, f3, gf, gf, c6, dc6, bc6, f2, c7. Now he goes rook c8, which is a very important move for him, because if rook b4 checking c5, if rook f8, rook takes f2. But after rook c8, now if I take f1 queen, I don't have time to queen, so I have to take on f2. He takes on c7, and I thought this is winning. Maybe it's not. So the lines I looked at was rook f6, king d7, and here I had either knight f5, rook c6, rook f8, bishop b7, rook f7, but here king e6. This is actually a draw, it turns out, because this is just a theoretical draw. Black just checks on the a-file. And otherwise I had another line, which was not knight f5, but after rook f6, king d7, rook f7, king c6, rook f8, rook a7. But this must be a draw too. I wanted knight c4 to avoid king d7 because of rook takes a8, but I thought it should still be a draw. So this is what I should have done anyway. But from a completely winning position to get into such troubles was already not smart. But anyway, I played c5 right away, and then he went bishop d5. And now, I even missed this idea of knight f7, king takes f7, king takes d5, but it turns out it's also a draw. After rook b5, king d6, rook b3, and if king d7, rook d3, and king e6 is a draw. So instead I just kept on with my idea of rook c2. After rook a8, c6, dc6, bc6, rook a4. In advance, I had missed that after king c5. I mean, even bishop takes c6 might be a draw, but rook a6 is an immediate draw because c7, rook c6 check would even lose. So then I have to play king b5 and it takes everything, play king e5 and makes a draw. So after rook a4, I had to play king d3, king e5, c7, and here I missed one forced draw with rook a8. So if I play c8, queen, rook takes c8, if rook takes king d6, and g2 pawns false, and if knight c8, bishop e4, king d2, bishop c2, king c2, and now even the simplest is f3 and king f4, which is a draw of two. So after rook a8, I could try knight c4 check, but bishop c4, king c4, rook c8, king b5, and now probably the easiest is g4, king c6, king e4, and it's again a draw. But I mean, I think he kind of saw it, but decided to play bishop e6, and then it should still be a draw, but he panicked here. For instance, bishop f5 is by far the best move. He allowed my king here, and then I don't know, I would have played king g7. In general, I think here I played king c5, I guess. Here I would have played king g7. He played king e7, it allows rook g6, which is I mean, it should be winning now, but so I played rook g8, bishop e6. No, wait. How did it go? So king e7, rook g6. Oh, yes, of course, he played rook a2. Trying to get counterplay. So rook g5. Bishop c8, now rook g8, bishop e6. Now it makes sense because I can play rook g6, attacking the knight as a bishop because rook takes e6 is a threat. So he had to play bishop c8. And now. Yes, now I finally had the winning move with knight d6. And after. He didn't play rook c2, but he played rook a5. But this check, take, king takes, and knight takes e8, and this pawn endgame is winning. So there was not much he could do. He played rook a5. I just played king b4. Now if rook a8, knight takes e8, rook c8, rook c6, and we will get down to the same pawn endgame, which is winning because I have the opposition. So he just tried rook e5, but then I played the easiest. I brought my knight to b5 to go to d4 and f3. Then I two shot any counterplay and it's completely winning. So he resigned.